If you broke the law at the U.S. Capitol last week, law enforcement probably knows who you are. At least 170 criminal cases have been opened and scores of arrests already made, and the charges being levied carry serious jail time.
Now, it must be difficult for the QAnons, or Q-berts, as they are never called. But if they're sad and looking for ways to spend hours on the internet researching arcane and impossible-to-understand theories, might I suggest nerd culture?
Oh yeah, I forgot. So I'm going to do another lecture today, actually. This is going to be short. I promise it's going to be short. So this is DJ Radon from TTM Academy. Shout out to all my students, listeners, subscribers. And if you are watching now, please like and subscribe. If you've already subscribed, thank you so much. All right, so this is another video. This is actually about that guy, the guy that stormed the Capitol, one of the terrorists that tried to do a coup on and stop the voting process and all that stuff. They try to stop the senators. The QAnon Shaman. So this is about the QAnon Shaman. So a couple of days before the QAnon Shaman, stormed, raided the Capitol in the riot, and with the terrorists, and they tried to do a coup or whatever. They had a failed botched coup. That QAnon Shaman guy, who's in jail now, he actually, he's got a bunch of symbols on his body and stuff like that. And, with TTM Academy, we deal with symbols a lot, and, the science of symbols and the history of symbols, the history of different notational symbols. And we'll be doing a lot more symbol, research and, lectures in the future, but we're going to go over some of the symbols that, the QAnon Shaman was wearing. But we're also, I'm going to point out something that a lot of people haven't pointed out. So that's the main part of this lecture, is the one thing that people haven't really pointed out. Shout out to Asir. I remember I was listening to an Asir lecture, and he was making the connection with the QAnon Shaman dude. And, this is the year of the ox that we're coming in. And that's a very, very important point. So I'm going to start off on that key point. I'm going to flip around. All right. So let's look at here. So, right now we're in the year of the ox, right? And that's a, an important thing to think about. But also, there's a lot of other characters that have horns. And just a couple of days before the QAnon Shaman thing happened with this guy right here, this QAnon Shaman guy, a couple of days before that, I had just released another page from my blackface chart about Krampus. And you can see here there's a lot of similarities and parallels between the QAnon Shaman and Krampus. And for those that don't know, Krampus is a, this is him represented as Belsnickle within the US, but he has different names all over Europe. And it's basically, he's Santa Claus's Christmas counterpart. He's a black man. Sometimes he's represented as a Moor. Sometimes he's represented, there's a lot of different ways they represent him, but they always represent him with horns, right? So you see he's got horns right there, right? They got the horns right here, right? So you got the horns right there. They got the horns right here. So, obviously this guy's, has a lot of symbols on him, and he's representing a lot of different things. So if you go on the web right now, you can see there's already a whole wealth of, things breaking down his symbols and stuff like that, but I'm just pointing out this one symbol that all these sites aren't really talking about, because they got this down. Like, he's got the Valknut on him, and I'll read about that. So it says, the Valknut, or knot of the slain, is an old Norse symbol that often represented the afterlife in carvings and designs. It is often considered a symbol of the Norse god Odin. Some Euro-diaspora supremacists, particularly the R-word Odinists, have appropriated the Valknut to use as a R-word symbol. They often use it as a sign that they were willing to give their life to Odin, generally in battle. Non-R-word pagans may also use this symbol, so you should carefully examine it in context rather than assume that a particular use of the symbol is the R word. And the reason I'm saying the R word is because, you know, YouTube, they might flag me if I actually say the full word, R-A-C-I-S-T, right? You know? Okay, so I'm just looking, showing you some of these symbols here. And right, so they put all the symbols on his hands. These are just the planets. He's got the planets in his hand. That's not a biggie. But I was just pointing out that, you know, we know that these people that stormed the Capitol were supremacists of the Euro diaspora, right? So, you know, we can also connect, you know, he's got all these symbols, right? So we know that the Valknut is used by a lot of nationalist, white nationalist groups and stuff like that.
Across the park, a man in a soon-to-be infamous set of horns. Jake Angeli is the QAnon Shaman.
The infamous rioter marching through the Capitol in a horned helmet and spear is pleading today for President Trump to pardon him. Jacob Chansley faces more than 20 years in federal prison if convicted. Federal prosecutors say rioters, including Chansley, intended to capture and assassinate elected officials, although they later walked back that allegation.
1 minute after Pence was hustled out of the chamber, a group charged the stairs to a second floor landing in the Senate.
It's also being revealed that dozens of people who were in D.C. on the day of the riot are reportedly on the FBI's terrorist screening database, which has a massive set of names flagged as potential security risks. The list of accused insurrectionists under arrest is growing. 33-year-old Jacob Anthony Chansley, self-described...
On January 9th, Jake Angeli, real name Jacob Anthony Chansley, was charged with violent entry of the Capitol and disorderly conduct.
The QAnon Shaman, that's what he calls himself. He's the fool with the painted face and the weird horns on his head.
All right. So, you know, and I'm just making that connection that, you know, obviously in the net, you know, he has all these like Gnostic things in here. These are just the planets. Right. But also here, if you see here, he's got some runes. But the funny thing is, he doesn't even realize these runes are actually from black people. And I've actually got that. I could show that. I'll probably show that just in the enhanced version. But these runes, you know, they've actually proven that, you know, a lot of these runes were made by, I believe, the Igbo tribe. You know, when we talk about the dwarfs and the black Pataites and pygmies that were living in Ireland, you know, called leprechauns and stuff like that, you know, that created all these runes. These are actually ancient African symbols, which is funny because anytime, you know, the Euro supremacist people try to, use their symbols, they're always, you know, we already created all the symbols, you know, eons ago. So it's like they're just kind of regurgitating a lot of our own symbols, right? So, but I just wanted to show this whole Krampus thing and the connection. Let me see. Let me get this off the desktop. Let me see. All right, so I'm going to, let me see, desktop. All right, so these are some things I got on the desktop. So yeah, so this is, you know, he's got the Mercury symbol on his fingers. He's got all the planets, but, you know, one of the animal figures that represents Mercury is also, you know, the ram, you know, amongst others. Also the turtle too, as well. You know, the turtle, you know, a lot of people call America Turtle Island or whatever, but the turtle shell is, or people used to call America Turtle Island, but the turtle shell is, you know, one of his things too. But I'm not even really getting into that. I'm just getting into the fact that, you know, he's dealing with a lot of symbols, and we know that he's a Euro supremacist. So let me go over here. I'm going to flip back to where I was before when I had all the blackface stuff. So yeah, I made this chart. So basically this is all I was just trying to show. I'm just showing, this is a very short lecture. I'm about to end it in about a minute or two. I was just showing the connection between that dude and all of this stuff right here. Like you can see, you know, and it's just kind of interesting too, that he's kind of walking in with a bunch of guys with beards and stuff like that. But, you know, this Krampus character is a Euro supremacist character that's found all throughout Europe. And, you know, he's got chains around his neck, but it's just kind of an interesting motif to think that maybe there is some kind of connection. You know, obviously, you know, he goes to all different types of protests wearing the same getup. But when you look at the history of the getup with the horns and that, you know, that's kind of a traditional European form of ridicule to ridicule of black people to wear horns and paint one's face. And, you know, so I'm just making that connection, just a quick little connection. For those that never heard of Krampus, this is Krampus, right? So I'm going to look at Krampus, and then we're going to look at the actual guy. Let's see. Where is he? Let's see. And, you know, shout out to the homie here, too. He was pointing out that this symbol is also very similar to, like, a lot of the Pizzagate symbols, right? Like the kind of at triangular symbol and stuff like that. You know, there's a lot of... a lot of symbolic stuff that these people are doing, all right? Because it's, you know, it's beyond just them storming the Capitol. You know, those are also a lot of symbolic gestures. I'm going to, let's see me hit this thing again so I can look at the whole screen. Okay, boom. So, yeah, I was just showing this right here. So it's like you can see him and he's got his homie right next to him. But, you know, you can see it's an actual tradition of, you know, this actually comes from an actual tradition. This is them doing it in Italy. This is in America, you know. So, and the fact that he has his face painted and he's got the horns and the furry hat and the, you know, the staff, the American flag next to him is a very similar motif because, you know, he's also called Belsnickle, and Belsnickle also, you know, holds the staff, holds, you see that in his hand. He's got the branch and, you know, he's got the paint on his face and he's got the horns and the similar hat. So I'm just making that connection. All right. That's it. All right. Peace, y'all.
It was my calling since I was a child, but in all honesty, I always wanted to know what the Native Americans understood. I knew that they had something, that they didn't wear feathers like headdresses, and they didn't dress like this, you know what I'm saying, and drink plant medicines and, you know all the stars and the cycles of the earth and stuff. They didn't know all that for no reason. There was a reason for all that. I knew there was a reason for their ancient traditions, and I wanted to understand it in a deep and profound way.
What kind of world do you want to live in?
Well, I want to live in a world where we have a symbiotic relationship with the environment and each other.
Yeah.
Information uncritically.
Hello, everyone.
Today, President Trump's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, claims he was just quoting Game of Thrones during his controversial speech that preceded the insurrection.
Let's have trial by combat.
I demand a trial by combat.
Do you think we could ever get that in America?
Oh, dude, America's where it's going to start first.
Yeah? And do you think Donald Trump's the guy to do that?
I think Donald Trump is one of the people that is in a long line of people that is going to ensure that this happens. And he's the first of many, I will say.
So what happens in, like, what's a Biden world look like?
A Biden world looks like communist China.
Okay. How did that feel?
Fun. I was scared, but I felt alive.
But as the counting goes on for days and the media call the election for Biden, the tensions...
This is a peaceful demonstration. We're not going to argue with idiots. You don't play chess with pigeons. What's up, dude?
How are you feeling right now?
I'm beautiful, baby. I'm great. We're just trying to keep this whole thing peaceful and civil.
At what point in your life did you stop listening to the mainstream narrative?
When I realized that doing my own research brought me more information than listening to the news ever could. Mm. Once I stopped allowing the news to make up my mind or my narrative for me, I grew exponentially, not just politically, but spiritually, intellectually, and physically. You know, because, I mean, I was actually able to take the information that I was absorbing and apply it to my activist routine.
Angeli addresses the crowd about the QAnon worldview, in which Trump wages war against a cabal of satanic pedophiles.
So Q most certainly did send me, ladies and gentlemen. Q is the highest levels of the military and the intelligence community in the United States. And they are disseminating above top secret information to patriots in our republic. That means people like you, so that we can take back our country from the communists and the globalists who have infiltrated our government at some of the highest levels and some of the lowest levels, like pollsters, so that they could bring us down from the inside, ladies and gentlemen, because they knew there's a gun behind every blade of grass, and they couldn't take on the American military. So they had to try to sneak in the back door, but we caught them, baby!
And I want to tell you, it's really important. We should stop calling people fools, because we have a large percentage of our population who spent a great deal of time in their lives hanging on every word of President Trump. He loved Trump, every word. He listened to him. He felt like he was answering the call of our president.
Look at this. These protesters are inside Statuary Hall.
In the eyes of the law, doing what his president called for doesn't necessarily make him innocent. The bigger question for America is, what does it make Donald Trump, and where does it leave his supporters?
Now, after the inaugural, Q followers got a dose of reality from one Q Forum administrator who posted, "We have a new president sworn in, and it is our responsibility as citizens to respect the Constitution," adding, "Please remember all the friends and happy memories we made together over the past few years." Turns out the real conspiracy theory was the cannibal lizard friends we made along the way. Now, it must be difficult for the QAnons, or Qberts, as they are never called. But if they're sad and looking for ways to spend hours on the internet researching arcane and impossible-to-understand theories, might I suggest nerd culture? Join us. It's great. I spend every waking moment I'm not on camera reading J.R.R. Tolkien or listening to J.R.R. Tolkien or reading about J.R.R. Tolkien and taking Tolkien quizzes and reading the Tolkien dictionary like this one and correcting the entries. Why be upset about fictional reptilian Satanists when you can be angry at the very real fact that Glorfindel got shafted in the Lord of the Rings movies? Look, I understand adding Arwen. I like that. Even Professor Tolkien knew she was an underdeveloped character added at the last minute to the novel. But why did they have to cut Glorfindel out? He defeated the Balrog at the fall of Gondolin. Does that not count for anything anymore? And please, no letters that Glorfindel himself was killed while defeating the Balrog. So was Ecthelion, Lord of the House of the Fountain. And that was against Gothmog. So what's your point? And I promise you, just like QAnon, you will sound crazy. And your family will beg you to find another outlet for your obsessive compulsive disorder. And no one will die. Except Gandalf when he fought the Balrog, too. QAnon's not the only right-wing nut jobs disappointed by the former president.